The Espresso Podcast is brought to you by Wave One Media. If you want to start your own show, visit thewaveone.com. It's Late Night Express. It's Late Night Express. It's Late Night Express, and for some reason, he's wearing jeans. And he doesn't have a hat on. Who is this man?
I want to do it because it's fun. It's fun to do bad things.
Yeah, Late Night Express. Shout 142. He never done a bad thing in his life. What it do? Yeah. He done a couple bad things, but no hood rat shit. He just rode his bike to Target, stole some sweetest fish. Yeah. In an icy. Just kidding. He would never take those things. They were samples. And if they were given to him, he would definitely say, "Case." What's up? No, for real. The closest I got to taking anything when I was a kid was like, remember they had those big, like, plastic containers with a bunch of candy in them? Who's not stealing those? Dude, I swear to God, my dad would steal stuff out of those. I'd walk around Meijer with my dad. Like, Meijer. Like, old school Meijer with my dad. He'd be like, let's go get some groceries. We'd need, like, two things and end up with, like, three carts full of shit. You know, every dad's like, I just need to run to the store. And then they come back with, like, four butterball turkeys. And you're like, why would we ever? He's like, they're on sale. Like, we're never going to need them. No, right when we walk into Meijer when I'm a kid, my dad would get a handful of prunes. Like, that was his, like, vice. And I'd be like, you can do that? And he'd be like, just one's fine. I was like, okay. Why prunes? They look like big roaches. And he's like, prunes. Dude, prunes are just big bugs. I get raisins. I've been off raisins, but prunes are big bugs, big wet bugs. I got them one time because I was like, oh, I'm going to switch my flow up because I was smashing raisins all last summer. Summer 2020, the summer of the raisins for your boy. That sun-kissed bitch, that's my girlfriend. That was my girlfriend last summer.
Have you, like, dated anybody?
Yeah, the sun-made girl. Dude, that was my girl all summer. She's looking all fine with the grapes. I tried her prunes. I, like, stuck up for them for, like, 10 steps down the road. And I was like, God. And then I ate, like, two more and then threw it away, reluctantly. Raisins all 2021, fam. Drake's next song.
Oh, yeah, oh, yeah. Raisins, oh yeah, oh yeah. They pruny, but I like them. They brown, and I pop them in my mouth like I hut-hut hike them. Yeah.
What's up, man? Now that we got that out of the way. Shout 142. Espresso Podcast, I'm Ben Polizzi. Remember to follow on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, Cameo. All that at Benedict Polizzi. I'll be posting stuff. Thanks for listening. Remember to subscribe, rate, review, tell your homies and homegirls, tell the espressos. Because it's fun, man. It's a good thing we got going on. Merch update. It's shipping to your house in probably 2 weeks. Sorry, dude. It's just one of those things. It's gonna take a minute to produce. Dude, I don't know how you guys are like that, but like, right after some people place their orders, they hit me up and they're like, when's it coming? I'm like, dude, just chill. After I order something online, I completely forget I order it. I get it in the mail and I'm like, oh, wow, what a surprise. That's what I do to surprise myself. I'm like, guess I'll order some shoes and then completely forget about them. Then they'll come in the mail and I'll be like,
yes!
Seriously, I hate people that are like, oh my God, I'm going to track my shipping every 15 minutes. No. I don't even know my tracking. I've never tracked a package. Who knows? I don't know. See it when I see it. But The merch will be coming soon, I promise. It's just, it's getting made right now, then I gotta ship it out. I'll hook you guys up. Just chill, baby girl. You'll get it. But all right, what's up? Why am I wearing jeans? I don't know. I've never really had a pair of jeans that I mess with. I just really just, they're the most uncomfortable thing. Have you ever been around somebody that sleeps in jeans? You're like, ah! I will crochet a pair of sweatpants for somebody that's sleeping in jeans. If you don't take off your jeans immediately when you get in the house. 911, what's your emergency? I don't know. I have them on now because I just came back from a show, so I don't have anything to change into. I do feel a little more like ready to go when I wear jeans, though. Like, after I put jeans on, I'm like, all right, let's do it. Like, if I was wearing sweats, I'd be like, jeans are like, how you doing? Sweats are like, what's up? Tuxedo pants are like, it's really good to meet you. I posted that picture on Instagram, like, of my face, like, exploding. I had that because I honestly ate St. Elmo's cocktail sauce. Like, I do it every time, and I'm like, this is a fine amount. I know it's going to be super hot, but this is a fine amount. Then I put it in my mouth, and I'm like, goodbye, world. I have to walk around and, like, say the Hail Mary in my head after I have one piece of shrimp. No, but I did that, and I took a picture of my face, and it was that. You know when you're like peak brain freeze? This is the exact opposite. And you're like, I can't! But yeah, that got a lot of good comments. I kind of want to read through them. What? I said, best caption gets a kiss. A lot of these made me laugh, but for like unknown reasons. Hey, bro, you want to choke each other for fun in the hall between classes? That was such a weird little phase that everybody had a friend that did. Anybody have a friend that just choked themselves and tried to make himself pass out all the time? Like, dude, like, seek help. I love just making myself pass out. Like, how bored do you have to be to just be like, just a Windows 95 yourself? How bored do you have to be to do this to yourself? What do you want to do at my friend's tonight? Come over, bro. I know what we can do. Come over tonight, bro. What's going on? Nah, we're just going to... Anytime somebody starts talking about a movie. Anytime somebody starts talking about how much money they made doing something. I can't stand it. Anytime somebody starts talking about their kids. Dude, when somebody starts talking about their kids, immediately, hey, have you seen my daughter? I'm like, why do I care? I think in order to care about somebody else's kids, you have to have kids of your own. Oh my god. Yeah, my son just started doing karate. And look at these pictures, me. Bye. And it's always a Facebook mom, you know? Facebook moms all look the same. They're like kind of overweight, like, and they have like one black strip of eyeliner on. And they're like, pretty. And they're so super talky. I'm like, Facebook moms are a whole entire army. Tin hut! Drink! They all sip a Diet Coke. March! Tell all about my kids. Tell all about my kids and my nursing job. Get in my Prius. Dun, 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 dun. Drink. Talk shit about my husband that I met in high school. Talk shit about my husband. Dun, 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 dun. Go out with my high school best friends. naked trash and cry about my husband. And I'm the server at their table, and this is me when they ask me for a 14th round of drinks. Anyway. Dun da da dun da da dun dun dun. All right, let's get to the question. It was, I don't know why I thought of this. Something your girlfriend, boyfriend, or best friend does that sucks and you hate, but you just let it slide because they're like your homie, you know? Like, everybody has something, man. I got a friend that's like super into country music, and it's like, when are you going to change it? That's the only thing that's on my mind the whole time. It's like, what do you want to listen to on the way to the party? What do you want to listen to on the way to the party? And I'm like, just normal shit. I don't know. I'd rather listen to nothing, honestly, on the way to a party. He'd be like, bam, 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 bam. It's Sunday night and I'm a little sad. Don't know what's in store for me. But I look on top of the flight of stairs and my baby girl is waiting for me. Bow, meow, meow. When somebody plays country music. Bow, meow. I gotta figure out that song now. All right. The question of the week. What's something your best friend does or your friend does that you hate, but you let it slide because they're your friend? Here we go. Always lies about how much his clothes are. Oh my God. I honestly kind of do that too. Because I don't want to like, I buy the dumbest shit. If somebody's like, how much are those? I don't want to be like, it was like very unreasonable and I shouldn't have bought it type of amount. Like, that's every time. How much was that? I'm always like, I should probably say 40 less than it was, just to make myself seem sane. How much were those shoes? I'm always like, 150, like, but there's a sale, so they're 120. And then they make a face, and they're like, I'm like, but there's another sale, and they're 100. And they're like, oh. And I'm like, but then this thing happened, and I saw that a part of it was, like, missing on the shoe, so they're only 80. And he's like, that's what's up. And I walk away, and I'm like, I can never tell the truth about shit that I buy because I buy the dumbest crap. How much was that jersey, bro? I'm like, I got it like at TJ Maxx, crazy steal. Really bought it online with like express shipping for double the amount. To wear it on like some weird Wednesday when I'm going to Panera and getting coffee. I just wanted to like ball out. That was Wector Media, by the way. Chief Zigzag, stuff your friends do that you hate, but you let it slide. I got a homie that be talking to every girl he sees in one day. No cap. Literally try to fuck anything with a vagina in a pulse. I hate guys like that, dude. Guys that ask you what happened between you and a girl are the guys that I hate. Or guys that brag about stuff they did with a girl. I'm like, all you're saying right now is that you've never had sex. That's that, dude. Dude, me and her, we like. I'm like, dude, you've only kissed. That's cute that you've only kissed up to this point. Do not tell me what you've done with a girl. But then on the other hand, girls are completely opposite. I feel like when a girl does something with a guy, she runs off and tells all her friends every single like gruesome detail. I'm like, oh. Yeah, he was like this, and he did this, and he made this noise. And oh my God, before, like, he took his shoes off right when we, like, every single detail. He, like, coughed while we were doing it. I thought it was so crazy. And then he sneezed. Oh my God, I was like, do you have COVID? But I didn't say it, obviously. But yeah, and then we did this, and then we did this. And the weirdest part, like, right before, he brushed his teeth. Ew, like, oh my God, like, ew. Minty mouth. I call him Minty mouth. I call him Eminem now. Like, not the rapper, though. If a guy ever asked me what happened between me and a girl, I'd be like, we butterfly kissed, that's all. Our eyelashes touched. Then we went home. Sorry. stuff your friends do that you hate, but you let it slide anyway. I line back, punches me in the arm or leg whenever he's laughing. I'm the worst person of all time with that. If something's funny and we connect, like, you better run to Louisville. I will beat the shit. I will carry you around the town like it's your birthday. Happy birthday. If we connect on a good, like, laugh that's strange and no one else is, like, we're best friends forever. If we're beating the shit out of each other in a public place and laughing, like, I'm going to be at your Christmas. Dude, seriously. Bruises and shit. I've actually done that and hurt people, but I'm like, it's so funny that I don't give a fuck. After me and you are laughing hard, you better just bounce. See ya. Start your car. Stuff your friends do that you hate, but you let it slide because they're your friends. Matt Gibbons, when you're blatantly trying to get off of a FaceTime call and they just keep going on to other stories. I don't get how people can't, like, see that you're done talking. If that happens to me and they're like, all right, I'm like, see you, bye, 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 bye. Don't even say bye to me, just go. You ever have somebody talk to you for so long that you think they're kidding? You're like, this cannot be the real thing. And then when they finally, like, are like, all right, I'll see you later, it's, like, kind of rude. And you're like, did I say something? Then you start feeling bad that they just wasted 40 minutes of your time. Like, once somebody looks at their phone, bye. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. That's it. The golden rule of shutting the fuck up. When you're talking to someone, they look at their phone or they break eye contact with you. Drive to Louisville. Luke Santa. Stuff your friends do that you hate, but you let it slide because they're your friends. I swear to God, every single one of my closest friends doesn't know how to breathe normally when they eat. It sounds like they're in the middle of a marathon when they're eating a bowl of cereal. I sound like a goddamn train when I eat. My nose is whistling and shit. You know you're comfortable with somebody when you can just eat like a savage in front of them. Girls always eat with their hand over their mouth. I'm like, come on, dude. Seen you naked. Whoops. Seen worse than you eating sushi. Brian Price, 12. Stuff your friends do that you hate, but you let it slide because they're your friends. Always have a friend who can't be the one playing music with either a few of us or a large group. I swear, when Bluetooth wasn't a thing and we had an auxiliary cord to play music, I think he carried one with him or had, like, one up his ass or something. I hate it. Always has to be a DJ. Damn, I was that guy too. I really thought I was, like, an auxiliary DJ at one point in my, like, college career. I was like, I know the songs, all right? Okay, that's what I thought. And go on to play, like, a Tyga song. For real, though. People hate on Tyga. Tyga's my favorite rapper. What's your baggage? Tyga's my favorite rapper. Okay, I know the songs, all right? So just trust me on this one. Just let me handle it. This is the only song I played. This. Stick out your tongue, girls, when I have fun. I love Tyga, bro. I swear to God, he's my favorite rapper. Like, if I'm being dead serious, Tyga's, like, in my top three. He's so... Nigga, yeah, I did it, and it can be undone. Like, who has that voice? Listen to this voice. Listen to this. Like, seriously, just listen. I know. I've heard Tyga. Listen. I'm the cream with the crop, and I know you want some. No way. No one has that voice. I've been growing with the money since Young Money. Dude. What if you really just talked like that? Sir, would you like to donate $5 to the St. Jude's Children Fund? Tyga's just like... Yeah. Tyga, you know a date is coming up, right? Tyga's like, yeah. What's your plans? What is it, huh? What is it? You don't remember my special day? And he's like... Yeah. It's your birthday, can a nigga get you some? Tyga. Top three. Not ashamed. Tyga. Every song sounds like that, though. Every Tyga song sounds like that. I don't care if you're like a hip hop enthusiast. Like the first time you heard this, though. Yeah, bro. You're like, what is that? My uncle could have been like in a car and just like flip. He might have been scanning. Does anyone scan radio stations anymore? And he scans one more time and all he hears is this. He slows down the car. That's the next TikTok trend. Play this sound in front of your parents and see if they're like, what was that? You know that song's about to be fucking tight.
That song's lame, Rack City.
I swear to God, every time I walk into Starbucks. Every time I talk to a girl, but I don't stutter. When I flip the lights on in my apartment and the fan doesn't go on too. The most lame shit ever. When I floss, brush, and take my contacts out before bed and I lay there and it's like a reasonable time and I shut my eyes. When I jog and my leg doesn't hit my other leg. Okay. Let's do a couple more.
I'm the cream of the crop and you bitches want some.
Stuff your friends do that you hate, but you let it slide because they're your friends. Rocco_P. I hate when my friend tells me about their dreams. I don't care what happened to you and you're not real. Make-believe imagination scenario that doesn't matter affect me. It's the realest shit he's ever read. Oh my god. When somebody tells me about their dreams. The number one answer. Right when someone starts, oh my god, I had this dream last night. Oh my god, I had this dream last night. Everybody within a 2-foot radius.
I'm the cream of the crop and you bitches want some.
Okay.
Let's go viral.
Hashtag don't trust people who. I'm sorry, but I don't trust anybody that's like super religious. People that go to church, I'm even like, once you get to a certain age, it's like, just talk to God, all right? You don't need to go and like worship. Worship. And you especially don't need to put it in your social media. I'm just going to start putting my faith in my social media. Saint Rock Parishioner. How weird would that be? When people post about like their church all the time, I'm like the one thing that you wouldn't want to brag about is that, right? I go to church! Fuck me. I go to church. Want to have sex? Like, who are you trying to impress? Oh my god, she's so faithful. Hashtag four words for my age. Four words for my age. Will you preheat? Preheat the oven. I text my roommate like 5 times a month, and 4 out of the 5, I'm like, yo, will you preheat for me? Question mark. And then the fifth one is like a picture of a leather couch that we'll never buy. But we're like, this would be tight. Hashtag immature things I have done. Literally, when someone still says come, I'm like, I don't laugh at the fact that it's that word. I just laugh at the fact that like you said that. Like I won't laugh, but if I look up and someone looks at me, then I'm like, all right, we're best friends. But let's laugh in like 2 minutes. It's so funny. It is still funny. It is. Sorry. Yeah. And then you know what? He came too. I'm like, oh god. Like, bro. Word choice. It's still like worth a look around the room to see if anybody else is on your page. Because if we make eye contact and start laughing, just go ahead and drive to Louisville. Hashtag strange and unusual hobbies. hobbies. Do I have any? No. Do I want any? Absolutely not. My strange and unusual hobbies. I don't do anything unusual. I really should, though. I sing to bunnies. I don't know. That's kind of a hobby. But that's like a thing, you know? Who doesn't? If you see a bunny and you don't sing to it, like, you're fucked up. If you see a bunny and you don't react, like, you're insane. Every time I've ever seen a bunny, I'm like, oh, holy shit. I act like it's a goddamn T-Rex. Dude, bunnies are, and yeah, I still call them bunnies. Immature shit that I do, still call them bunnies. Rabbits? I've seen a rabbit. I'm like, God. Be more psycho. Did you see that rabbit? I'm like, you definitely kill like 30 rabbits a year if you say rabbit. That's it. Hashtag a blessing in disguise. I swear to God. But I used to think it was a somebody was like, it's a blessing in disguise. And I was like, wow, that is such a like large compliment. I was like, that is amazing. He just said it was a blessing in disguise. I was like, you must have really changed your life. And then I saw it written out and I was like, I think I said it like twice before I saw it. I was like, wow, those shoes are available? Wow, you got those shoes? Oh my God, that's a blessing in disguise. Oh my God, they were open? No way. And you got, that's a blessing in disguise. Those two people I talked to were probably like, we gotta go. Hashtag explain the opposite sex poorly. Explain the opposite sex poorly. Cheese. That's it. That's it. That's the end. Cheese. Name one girl that doesn't like cheese. Do it. Do it. Do it. One. One. That's it. Even if they're lactose intolerant, they're like, fuck. I'm going to take three of my pills so I can down this fucking charcuterie. So I can down this fresh Mott's. All right. Holy shit, dude. Those 2 days. Tuesday. National Popcorn Day. Remember popcorn reading in school? That's the only, I don't want to talk about real popcorn because I'll talk about it for 125 minutes. That divided popcorn you get for Christmas. I know you don't want it, but guess what? You're eating it. Mm-hmm. And I know you don't want to admit it, but yeah, the cheese is the best one. I know you think the caramel is, but guess what? It's overwhelming. And the plain is pretty good, but you're like, I always eat plain popcorn, so the cheese is the best. And that's that. Thursday, National Granola Bar Day. You ever eat so many granola bars, your jaws? Dude, I on the way to this show I did tonight, I ate a Clif Bar and a Kind Bar back to back, and I couldn't even feel my goddamn face. It only happens at random times. Like, I'll smash, like, 10 granola bars and be like, oh, God, that was good. But sometimes I'll just eat one and I'll be like, I'm about to have a lockjaw from this Kind bar, from this Luna bar. How do you get such a strong jawline? I just sit at home and eat Chewy bars all day. Oh, it's so sexy. Thursday, National Hugging Day. There's always some girl that always wanted to hug you, like, in middle school and shit. Remember that? Remember hugging was, like, the hugest deal? That was, like, the only way you could, like, show affection or something without, like, getting in trouble at our school. Like, if you had a girlfriend, you'd, like, hug her on Friday and be like, that was our kiss. You ever give somebody a side hug and they, like, get offended? Like, that's my style. Ew, you're not gonna, like, full hug me? I'm like, you're not my uncle on Christmas. We're literally leaving Einstein Bagels. Like, it's, I don't have to make out with you right here. You side hug me? I'm like, bro, yeah, it's just like not that big of a deal. Like, it still means a lot to me. Like, it's a tight side hug. Like, it's not like a loose, like, ugh. But hugging when we were younger was like such the sex move. You hug somebody and crack their back, it's like, yeah. Think about that. It's so fucked. Friday. Oh, National Squirrel Appreciation Day, Thursday. I don't really have any appreciation for squirrels. I guess squirrels kind of don't really bother anybody. If squirrels were, like, going through your trash and shit, it'd be one thing, but squirrels don't really do anything that weird. And they're, like, not bad looking. You ever see a squirrel, like, in the South, though? It's, like, the size of a wood chip. And squirrels in the Midwest, you're like, does that have a collar on it? Is that? We need to knock some doors and see who lost their goddamn dog. Come here. Come here. It would, like, literally come to you, too. Come here, nuts. You ever watch a squirrel eat a nut and just think, holy shit, they've never been more in the zone. Every time I see a squirrel eating a nut, like on a power line, I'm like, hey, have you ever had food? It's like me eating at Chipotle. If I haven't eaten like all day and I eat Chipotle, I look exactly like a squirrel eating a nut. I'm like, you know that weird noise it makes when they're like, scratching their teeth on it? That's me. Let's go to Chipotle. All right. Where you gonna sit? Right here. Okay. This is gonna be so good. Like squatting on the seat too. Friday. Celebration of Life Day. The cereal though, not the actual thing. The fact that it was called Life, like, hey, it better be fucking good. What should we call it? Wheat shreds? How about square yums? Nah, I got something better. What? Hexagons? Nah. Deeper than that. Shit. Hashtags. Nope. Mm-mm. I got one better for you. Let's call it existence. So dramatic for cereal. What are you doing with your life? Saturday, National Handwriting Day. Let's not even get into that. I was thinking about it though. Like, guys have the worst handwriting, but like, if a guy's ever broken up with a girl, like, guys, to the fellas, you definitely write a letter. You just do. It's like in a guy's DNA. You're like, man, I need to be as sincere as possible. I'm going to handwrite this letter. The girl has to see it and be like, okay, can't read this shit at all. And thank you. Bye. Prove my point. Sunday. National Compliment Day. National Compliment Day. I give like the strangest people. I can't hold back. If I see somebody with nice shoes, it's a wrap, dude. I'm talking about them. Oh, dude, this is weird. I'll tell anyone that they smell good. I could walk by like the most random group of people. I'm like, you smell good. And they're like, thanks. Somebody that smells good is fucking fabulous, though. People that smell good will take over your life, bro. That is such a thing. Looking good is one thing, but if somebody looks gross and they smell good, I'm like, well, there could be something there. Literally. Like, you could be a ugly beast and smell good, and I'd be like, I wonder what their Instagram is. I always get, like, stuck on one smell. For some reason, when I'm picking out deodorant, like, if I go away from my smell for, like, one round of new deodorant, I'm like, I can't. I gotta find my stuff. My stuff. Everybody knows I smell like Old Spice Fiji. They know that. That's, like, my thing. Like, no one can even smell deodorant, and I spend 7.5 years picking it out. I'm like, sitting down on the deodorant aisle floor, like, tossing deodorant over my head. Perspirant, antiperspirant. Perspirant, anti. You ever see the deodorant that's antiperspirant but not deodorant? Or in vice versa, deodorant but not antiperspirant? They're like, oh, you smell good. See you later. You wave to him. It's full pit stain. See ya. When people have pit stains, it's just shocking. I'm like, damn, bro. Why is that still the most embarrassing thing to me? Pit stains. When somebody raises their arms and they have pit stains, I'm like, holy fucking shit, you're a monster. Will you get it together? Pit stains are so... Pit stains in pictures. Nothing worse. Is that... That should have been, like, the first, like, Photoshop tool. Red eye and pit stains. Pit stains. Brad Pitt. Okay, Brad Pitt. I'd rather have my fucking... I'd rather have my dick out than a pit stain. I'd rather be showing my full ass than have a pit stain, dude.
Ew, he's gross.
Like, imagine putting a pit stain, like, as your profile picture and just being like, whatever, I don't know, it's just me. Like, yeah, it's just you and you smell like shit. All right. Shout, well, that was shout 142. Thanks for listening. Merch is coming soon. Remember to follow on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and Cameo. All at Benedict Polizzi. Subscribe, rate, review the pod. Leave a little review. Little review. Let's grow this thing. I'll have some guests on soon. I'm going to do some. I'm lining up some shows soon. I'll get the details out. But okay. I'll talk to you guys next week. FM.
Rack City bitch, rack city bitch, rack city bitch, 10 10 10 20s on your titties bitch, 100 deep VIP, no guest list, TT raw, you don't know who you fucking with.